In this video, we are going to be looking at Kirchhoff's voltage law of DC circuit. Okay, we start with the definition. It states that for a closed loop series, but the algebraic sum of all the voltages around any closed loop in a circuit is equal to zero. Okay, that's exactly what we have here. That means total voltage is equal to zero. Now, but there is another way you can define this. That the algebraic sum of EMFs is equal to the algebraic sum of IRs, and this is what I'm going to be using to teach us in this particular video. So the total EMF, the algebraic sum of the EMF, is equal to the algebraic sum of IR. Okay, the next thing we are going to be looking at here is the sign convention, because when we talk about algebraic sum, it means that we need to take the issue of sign convention seriously. And we are using summation of E to be equal to summation of IR. Now we look at this first diagram here. You see that the direction of your loop, we take a loop. Usually in Kirchhoff's rule, you take a loop. Let's assume we have this circuit. So your loop is usually in a clockwise direction. Okay, so if the direction of your loop is going from negative to positive potential, it means that your E will definitely be positive. Okay, if the direction of your loop is going from positive to negative potential, it means that your E is going to be negative. Now, coming for resistors, I taught us in the previous video that when you go from positive to negative, when current is entering the resistor, that point where it enters the resistor is positively charged, and the point where it's leaving the resistor is negatively charged. Okay, so in this case now is reverse, sort of. If the direction of the loop is in the direction of the current, then your IR will be positive. If the direction of loop is in the direction of current, your IR will be positive. And if the direction of the loop is in opposite direction of the current, IR will be negative. Now this is important. Now please note that this is sign convention. If we are using summation of E equal to summation of IR, is not the same thing as for summation of V, just a slight difference. Okay, now let's see an illustration here. We look at this loop, we look at this particular circuit. Now we take our loop, you can see the direction of the loop, which is a clockwise direction. Now if we come here, you can see that VS, the direction of the loop, is going from negative to positive, so your VS is definitely positive, which is exactly what we have here. Now if we continue in the direction of our loop, you can see that it is going in the same direction of the current, so that is why IR is positive here. Then coming here too, the same thing, is going in this direction of the current, and that is why IR2 is positive. Okay, so that's the reason why we have this VS equal to IR1 plus IR2. Now since the current is common, we can say VS is equal to I into R1 plus R2. Okay, so let's see another example here. Look at here, we have two loops. And if we take the first loop, let's consider loop one, which is this. In my direction of loop, you can see that V1 is going from negative to positive, so your V1 is definitely positive, and that's the only EMF you have in that loop. So V1 is equal to, now when you come here, okay, I just noticed our diagram here does not have direction of current. So in Kirchhoff's law, you assume a direction of current, so we assume our current here to be I1. Okay, and we assume the current going here to be I2. Then we assume the current coming down here to be I3. Okay, so in this case now, going this way is going in the direction of the current, so it is going to be equal to I1R1. Okay, now plus the same way here for I3 is going the same direction of the current, is going to be I1R3. Okay, no, sorry, I3R3. The current there is I3R3. Now that's the same thing for the second loop. Let's look at the second loop here. Remember that my current here is I3, is going downwards, and my current here for I2 is going this way. Okay, So if we look at this, the total EMF here, our direction is going this way, going from positive to negative terminal, is going to be minus V2. Okay, it's going to be equal to, now if you consider for R3, you can see that the direction of my loop is opposite the direction of the current, so it's going to be minus I3 R3. Now, but for R2, the direction of my loop and the direction of the current is the same, so it's going to be plus I2 R2. Okay, so when we get that, we can now solve simultaneously to get whatever we are asked to find. Now, let's look at this very question. We want to find the current in each of the arms, in each arm. So we can call the current here I1. Okay, we can call the current here I2. And we can call the current here I3. Now, I want you to see the current relationship here, that I1 is equal to I2 plus I3. So I1 is entering the junction and splitting into I2 plus I3. I want you to note the direction. Now, if we take our loop one, consider the first loop, we take this loop, you can see that the EMF here, the total EMF here, for 20 volts is going from negative to positive, so it's going to be 20. Now, but continue, the other EMF here is going to be minus 10, because going in that direction is going from positive to negative, so we have minus 10 volts now, which is equal to the direction of the loop is in the same direction of the current, and that gives us 3 I1. Okay, so 20 minus 10 is actually 10, equal to 3 I1. So here we can see that our I1 is equal to 10 over 3, which is 3.33 amperes. So we've gotten our value for I1. Now let's continue there for the second loop. Okay, so in the second loop here, we have that for the second loop, we have that considering the 10 volts, you can see we have 10 I1. Okay, 10, the direction of the loop is going from negative to positive. Okay, let's make it clearer. So if I take my loop this way, you can see that for 10 is going from negative to positive, that will give us 10 volts. Now coming down here for 5 volts is going from positive to negative. That will give us minus 5 volts. Now, equal to the direction of my current here, remember, was this way, which is I2. So it's equal to 4 I2. Okay? So 10 minus 5 here is 5. 5 equal to 4 I2. So that means that I2 will be 5 over 4, which is 1.25 amperes. Now, with this, since we know the value for I1 and I2, we can easily find I3, because I3 now is equal to I1 minus I2. Remember, initially we stated that I1 is equal to I2 plus I3. So my I1 is 1.33, sorry, 3.33, then minus I2. I2 is 1.25. Okay, and that is going to give us 1.08 amperes. So we can see here that our I1 is 1.33, our I2 is 1.25, our I3 is 3.33. Please watch out for more examples in our next videos. Thank you very much.